Adding text layers to our images is easy with Snapseed from Google. I'll cover more advanced tricks in another tutorial, but for now, let's say that you just need to add some words to an image. Maybe you need to turn a photo into a birthday card, or maybe you need to add some words to an image to make a graphic for use on social media. A little text can help us turn an everyday photo into a strong message. Now, as much as this tutorial is about the text tool, the secret lesson here is all about some of the hidden features of the Edit Stacks control in Snapseed. Let me remind you of the way that the Edit Stack in Adobe Photoshop CC language, what we would call the layer panel, works in this app. Every time that you use a tool or filter to improve your image in Snapseed, you're creating a new edit layer, and these edits stack up from first to last on top of your original image. To get ready for this demo, I've already added two types of edits over top of my original image here. Tapping on the word original at the bottom of the edit stack will temporarily turn off all of the changes that I made using the tune image and the perspective repair tools on this image. As you can see, my original image was pretty dark, and those buildings, that's beautiful Nashville, Tennessee, were a little skewed. So now the text tool part. Most of the time, you're going to want to use the text tool after you've created all of your other edits, so that the text becomes the topmost layer in the edit stack. Let me show you what I mean. I'll tap here to return to Snapseed's main menu, and I'll create a new text layer by bringing out the Tools and Filters menu and tapping right here. When the text tool loads, I'll start by picking out the style of text and adornment that I want to use for my message. For this image, I'll go with the M5 style. Now, I can type out my message. In this case, I'll just type the word Nashville. Next, I can choose the color that I want for my message. I'm going to go with a bright orange here, since that matches the warm glow of the lights on my buildings, and since orange is also the color of the University of Tennessee. If I wanted my text to blend in more with the image beneath it, I can go to the opacity control, and then I can slide the opacity slider to the left to make my text more see-through. I can easily adjust the position of my text by dragging this layer around the screen with one finger. Those lines that pop up, by the way, those are smart guides to show me where the middle or the sides of the photo would be. If I press two fingers against the screen, I can use the pinch in or press out move with my thumb and forefinger to resize the text. Finally, if I press with two fingers against the screen, I can rotate the text around if I want to. Okay, so let's say that I'm happy now. I'll tap on the check mark in the bottom right to commit this text layer and to return to the main menu. At this point, I'm going to save my work. If I wanted to now, I could tap the share button to send a copy of this image off to a friend in an email or to post it to social media. You get the idea. Snapseed made adding a text layer pretty easy, and if I needed more text somewhere else in the image, then I could just keep adding additional text layers. I'm going to cancel out of the share options right now, though, to show you what would happen if you tried to add additional changes onto your image at this point. If I go into the Tune Image menu now, for example, and if I drag the saturation control all the way to negative 100, then my image goes to black and white. When we suck all the saturation out of our colors, we are left with a black and white world. This additional edit would be great if I wanted my text and my image to become black and white, but this move is a failure if what I really wanted was a black and white photo underneath the orange text that we had a minute ago. In this case, I'm not thrilled with what's happening here, so I'm going to tap on the X in the lower left to cancel this change. If I tap on the perspective layer, or whatever layer that you have that is just below your text layer, then the top layer, the text, will temporarily disappear. Snapseed has not deleted your text, it's just turned that layer off so that you can add additional changes now, and then you can turn the edit, the text, back on when you're ready. Let me show you what I mean. With the text layer turned off, I'm going to go back to the main menu. Now, I can go back into the Tune Image Tools again. I can go back to the Saturation slider, and I'll drop it all the way down, just like I did last time. Only this time, I'm going to commit this change. As you can clearly see, the whole image has become a black and white. But this is where things get really clever. If I go back into the Edit Stacks right now, you can see that my text layer is still disabled and that Snapseed was smart enough to wedge that new Tune Image layer, the change that I just made that took all the color away, in between my perspective tool and my text layer that's still up there on top. If I tap and re-enable the text tool, then voila, Snapseed will do a little calculating, and now we have a black and white image with full color text on top. Let me back out of the edit stacks, and I'll save this version too. Ready for one more demo? First, let me step back into the edit stacks real quick and get rid of that Tune Image layer that's taking away all the color here. When I tap on the Tune Image layer, you'll see a tiny little triangle appear on the left. If I tap on that tiny little triangle, a flyout menu will appear. Tapping on the trash can symbol in this menu will delete the make it black and white command without affecting any of the other edits. Most of the time, we want our text layer up at the very top of the stack so that nothing else that we have done to the image changes the color or the look of our text. But what about the other 10% of the time? Well, check this out. If I go back to the main menu now and I pick one of the filters, like grunge, then the effects this filter adds will be applied both to my image and to my text. Let me set things in the grunge filter this way. In this case, I think that looks pretty cool. I like the way the texture and sort of the distressed look is adding to both the photo and the text. Since I like what's happening here, I'm going to tap on the check mark to commit this change. In this case, I love the way that Snapseed is applying the new filter to both the image and the text at the same time. If I go back to the edit stacks, you'll see that that's because the grunge layer is above the text layer in the edit stack order. I don't think that I would want to use this trick all of the time, but every now and then, maybe 10% of the time, I love the unique looks that I can create by intentionally adding a filter or any additional edits over top of my text layers. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this lesson useful. I hope that it showed you how easy it is to add text over an image in Snapseed, and that it helped explain some of the powerful secrets that are hidden inside of the Edit Stacks feature.